Hey, today we're looking at cover crops. There's a new book out from the legendary Colin Seis, multi-species cover crops, and he's a sheep farmer, so he's integrated the two together. Really intriguing for all those market gardeners doing cover crops. And I'm also reading side by side, kind of the sister book or the twin book, Dirt to Soil, Gabe Brown, and they both tell the journey of rejuvenating their farm that was worn out with cover crops. So what's to learn from graziers when we're market gardeners? We're all dealing with sunshine, root exudates, pumping sugars and fats into the soil, and there's a lot to learn from their work. I'm really enjoying their work, and with our cover crops, it's Mother's Day, happy Mother's Day. As we go into winter, we are switching our outdoor production from summer cover crops to winter cover crops, and we're doing a lot of experiments. We're now 25 years cover cropping, and a big return of cover crops. Now we're growing a lot more indoors, and we are, our goal with annual crops where we're changing and flipping beds is we need to be able to drill back into the surface with tools like the five-row jang, single jang, and we're having some really good results with our ground covers. This year it kind of came back to us where we had a lot of buckwheat in, and a good friend Jules Matthews said to me, how come you're just doing single species? And I said, because I want to terminate it to be able to re-drill it. Buckwheat's a beautiful summer crop, but it's got such a strong fibrous root system that it's a mission to be able to drill back into it basically. We did, however, do some mixed species crops this summer, and one that was really successful was buckwheat drilled with daikon. Daikon's got a deep taproot, brings up minerals. And so the buckwheat took off, flowered, covered the ground. And then as the daikon came through, the daikon went up head high in full flower before we pulled the daikon. And at that point, the buckwheat was dead underneath and really easy to remove from the surface and just drill straight back in. We're not broad forking. We're literally running over the surface with the tilther and straight back in, same day with the five row jang. With the five row jang, we are also experimenting with a lot of the rollers that have the largest holes. When the holes get really big, you can only get 12 on there. And what I'm thinking at the moment is we're returning to diversifying our cover crops, but we're seeing the story from these two books. It's really important to have nitrogen fixes in there. Anytime we have crop residual that we need the soil to break down, we can have a nitrogen deficit, and so that's kind of the reasoning for getting the legumes back in. So we have we're drilling field peas, phacelia, what other ones are we doing? Tick beans, which is like a dwarf fava, and we're able to just drill that in the jang. And so we're doing four types of grains in three hoppers, and then the other two hoppers mixed nitrogen fixes as well. And we're really enjoying seeing a lot more diversity in the field, and just keeping that ground cover up, but diversifying the root systems and the plants from as many families as possible. This block of beds, 14 meters long, 9 beds, was buckwheat last summer, and the buckwheat went to full maturity and self-seeded. We cut everything above ground just with a blade on my weed eater with a body strap, super quick, and composted that, tilted the surface, and then we were able to get the five row jang back in with daikon, and we also had the buckwheat self-seed and germinate at the same time. So now we've got cooler nights, the buckwheat has done its job and the daikon's taking over, and these should be in all winter covering the ground. And we've been getting off a 14 meter bed a square meter compacted of daikon from one bed. So there's 9 square meters of, when this is mature, 9 square meters of plant material to be recycling and composting. We like the taproots because they just pull super easy to get into the compost. We're also composting a lot at the moment for our spring. And one other brilliant podcast that I highly recommend, you can hear it on the website Quorum Sense. They also have a podcast on Spotify. So Quorum Sense and the interview, Jono Frew is the interviewer. Amazing interview with Jamie Elizondo talking about what happens when we let our pastures and or cover crops go to maturity, and pretty very interesting conversation about the changes from pumping sugars through the photosynthesis process into the ground into fats and waxes and lignans, and just talking a lot to understand here, talking about the long-term carbons that we're putting in the soil by allowing our plants to maturity. This has always been John Jevon's focus of growing the plant to maturity. You have more carbon to recycle through the compost. Lots to think about. So we're really enjoying the return of the cover crops, which has been forced on us with double recession and now the new greenhouses being so productive. And this year we're really focusing on diversifying, doing lots of trials with mixed species crops and just getting to understand how they all behave in the five-row jang. The other thing we are looking at, or have always focused on, we're roughly, sometimes we're seeding twice, so we'll put all of the, let's say, larger seeds together, seed that, then put all the smaller seeds together and run back over the top with them, changing the seed rollers, and we'll notice we're getting really nice even results with the even spread of the seed on the beds. Hope you're well. Check out roebuckfarm.com for more of our podcasts and information on there, our upcoming events we have on farm, and check out new book, Winter Reading.